Hi students, myself Vivek Sajjan, teaching you science subject in Chandrakant Patil Center School, Kalburgi. Today we are going to discuss about the chapter motion and time. In class 6th, you learnt about different types of motions. You learnt that a motion could be along a straight line, it could be a circular, or it could be a periodic motion. So motion, in motions we have different types of motions. In that, straight line motion, periodic motion or circular motions. Can you recall these three types of motions? Okay, you have studied earlier classes also. So in table 13.1, give some common examples of motions, identify the types of motion in each case. So they have given the different types of motion in this tabular column. You can go through with this tabular column and you can write the different types of motion. So bullock cart moving along a straight road, it is a straight line motion. Hands of an athlete in a race, it's an example for the periodic motion. So pedal of bicycle in motion, so it is a circular motion. We have different types of motion, you can identify and you can write in this tabular column also. So it is common experience that the motion of some objects is slow while that some objects is fast. We know that the motion of some objects is fast and some object is very slow. So they have next given, they have that topic only, that is slow and fast. We know that some vehicles move faster than others. Even the same vehicle may move faster and slower in different times. So some vehicles will move very fast when compared to the other vehicles. For example, if you compare the aeroplane and auto rickshaw, so there is a lot of difference between the two vehicles. Okay. Or else we can compare the auto rickshaw with the cars. Okay. So make a list of 10 objects moving along a straight path. Group the motion of these objects as slow and fast. How did you decide which object is moving slow and which object is moving fast? By their velocity or by their speed, we can recognize that this object is moving fast and the other object is moving slow. If vehicles are moving on a road in the same direction, we can easily tell which one of them is moving faster than the other. Let us look at the motion of vehicles moving on a road. So you can see in this picture they have given. So vehicle moving in the same direction in the above picture. The black color is first and this faster. So little bit blue is little bit lesser speed and this ash gray color. Next is white, green, white, red. This one green, dark green. So like this, we can recognize the speed of vehicles which is traveling in the same path. Okay. So move the distance covered by you after 5 minutes would be much smaller than that covered by the bus. Would you say that the bus is moving faster than the bicycle? Yes, we can say. So we often say that the faster vehicles has higher speed. In a 100 meter race, it is easy to decide whose speed is the highest. One who takes shorter time to cover the distance of 100 meter has the highest speed. Which takes the shorter time to cover the speed, to cover the distance, then that is said to be as the fastest object or fastest thing. Okay. So we can conclude by this way also. Speed, you can probably familiar with the word speed. In the example given above, a higher speed seems to indicate that a given distance has been covered in a shorter time. The higher distance were covered by the higher speed in shorter time, or a longer distance covered in a given time. The most convenient way to find out which of the two or more objects is moving faster is to compare the distance moved by them in a unit time. So they have given you a unit time. For example, if two objects were left on a particular time, so in 1 minute, if the one object covers 1 kilometer, the another object covers 0.5 kilometer, then we can say we can distinguish the speed, or we can distinguish the distance covered by two objects easily. Okay. The most convenient way to find out which of the two or more objects is moving faster, it is compare the distance moved by them in a unit time. Thus, we know the distance covered by two buses in 1 hour, we can tell which one is faster. We call the distance covered by the object in a unit time speed of the object. So we call the distance covered by an object in a unit time as a speed of the object. When we say that a car is moving with a speed of 50 km per hour, it implies that it will cover a distance of 50 km in 1 hour. If the car is traveling 50 km per hour, then we can say that car will cover the distance of 50 km per hour. However, a car seldom moves with a constant speed for 1 hour. In fact, it starts moving slowly and then picks up speed. So when we say that the car has a speed of 50 km per hour, we usually consider only the total distance covered by it in 1 hour. So we do not bother whether the car has been moving with a constant speed or not during the hour. The speed calculated here is actually the average speed of the car. How we calculate the speed of the car means the average speed of the car. So in this book we shall use the term speed for average speed. So for us, the speed is the total distance covered divided by the time, total time taken. Speed is calculated by the help of total distance covered divided by the total time taken. So total distance divided by total time taken, it will give us the formula for speed. So we can determine the speed of a given object once we can measure the time taken by it to cover a certain distance. In class 6 you learnt how to measure the distance, but how do we measure time? Let us find out. Measurement of time is done by the seconds or minutes or by months or by years. Okay, so like this we will measure the times. So wall clock, time clock and digital clock, they are given. So this is how we measure the time: by seconds, minutes, hours, year, months. So like this we have different types of measurements of time. The simple pendulum consists of a small metallic ball or a piece of stone suspended from the resist stand by a thread. The metallic ball is called the bob. The metallic ball is said to be as bob. Here you can see the metallic ball and it is attached to a stagnant body or rigid body to a wall. Figure 13.4 shows the pendulum at rest in its mean position. For 13.4 it will shows the a simple pendulum which is in the rest position. When the bob of the pendulum is released after taking it slightly to one side, it begins to move to and fro motion. It will start to and fro motion. It will start moving from one end to the another end. The to and fro motion of a simple pendulum is an example for the periodic motion or oscillatory motion. We call this type of motion is known as periodic motion or oscillatory motion also. The pendulum is said to have completed one oscillation when its bob starting from its mean position O. They have given here O in this diagram. You can see the part 2, that is 13.4b picture, that is original place O. It will start moving towards A and afterwards once again it will come to the O and it will move forward to the B position and it will come once again. Like this the procedure will go on. This type of motion is known as periodic motion or oscillatory motion. So the time period means the time taken of this bob to travel one oscillation is known as time period. We can say like that also. So the table 13.2, the first observation shows is a just a sample. Your observation could be different from this. Repeat this activity a few times and record your observation by dividing the time taken for 20 oscillation by 20. Get the time taken for one oscillation or the time period of the pendulum. Okay, is the time period of your pendulum nearly the same in all the cases? No, we are having the different time period for in different cases. So that we can calculate the time period also. So says these clocks are called quartz. Quartz clock, you can see the time measured by quartz clock is much more accurate than that by the clocks available earlier. So the quartz clock will measure the time very accurately when compared to the earlier clocks. So this is what today's class. So if you have any doubts, please comment in the comment box. We will give the suggestion or we will give the answer for your questions also. So take care. Have a nice day. Bye guys.